ಸದಾಶಿವ ಸಮಾರಂಭ ಶಂಕರಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಮಧ್ಯಮಾಂ ಅಸ್ಮದಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಪರ್ಯಂತಾಂ ವಂದೇ ಗುರು ಪರಂಪರಾಂ. ಓಂ. ಪೇಜ್ 415 ವರ್ಸ್ 127. ನಿರೋಧಲಾಭಿ ಪುಂಸೋಂತಃ ಅಸಂಗಂ ವಸ್ತು ಶಿಷ್ಯತೆ ಪುನಃ ಪುನರ್ವಾಸಿತೇಸ್ಮಿನ್ ವಾಕ್ಯಾಜ್ಯಾಏತತತ್ವಧೀಹಿ. Listening to Vedanta or scriptural teachings is a very rare opportunity. Very few people get this opportunity. Even after coming to this scriptural study, very few people have an efficient quality learning or efficient in terms of quality and adequate in terms of quantity. Very, very few people have this opportunity also. Efficiency in terms of quality means listening with a quality mind without any preoccupation, with total commitment, but not as a time pass. Committed to the subject and more serious about the study of that scripture, either Gita or Upanishad or Prakarana Grantha, giving lot of time for that with a relaxed mind or without any preoccupation in the mind is called quality. Efficient in terms of quality and adequate in terms of quantity. Adequate means sufficient, necessary time of studying prasthanatrayam, complete study of Bhagavad Gita systematically without break. Without break in the sense, after studying second chapter and missing two chapters, coming later fourth chapter or fifth chapter, again two chapters break, again come 10th chapter, again break, come to the 12th chapter. Like that, suppose the inadequacy in study, that is called a lack of quantity. Quantitatively, if you are not adequate, that means consistent study of chapter by chapter, chapter by chapter. Why I am talking, if the gap comes, the long gap comes, the previous subject what you have received and the later subject what you are listening cannot have a connection. You know, with regard to your children, when they give you a long gap, 1 year gap, 2 year gap, even music, dance, what our children say, I have left 2 years back, now I am not able to sing. I have left 2 years back, I am not able to dance. Why they say like that? Same thing with regard to Shastra also. If there is a gap, if I don't study quantitatively enough, 18 chapters, reasonably sufficient Prakarna Granthas, what all I have to listen, those Prakarna Granthas I have not studied. Suppose Upanishads also quantitatively I have not studied. That is called inadequate in terms of quantity. Not if mind is also fully disturbed, anxious, and study, that is in terms of quality, is also inefficient. Inefficient because of lack of quality, mind. Inadequate because of lack of quantity in studying. Somehow or other, either knowingly or unknowingly, whatever may be the reason, but phalam, what comes is very, very less phalam. Very, very meager phalam only comes. That person cannot, without efficient in terms of quality, adequate in terms of quantity is not there, that person cannot claim I am Brahman. Suppose a person, a student, listen qualitatively with commitment, with sincere devotion, without any absence, too long gap, and feeling very bad for missing the class, that feeling should be there inside. Very few students have that feeling. If even they miss the class also, doesn't matter. But a sincere student feel very, very bad missing the class. That much commitment is there. That is called efficient in terms of quality. And what are all texts I have completed? Upanishads. Have I studied thoroughly, systematically, quantitatively? If a student does that way, the study, qualitatively, quantitatively, that student definitely claims, I am Brahman, I am liberated, I have understood the truth. There is nothing else is required other than this. That student can claim, no doubt in that. Without any doubt. But when there is no efficient in terms of quality study, no adequate in terms of quantity also, that student doesn't know what he is doing, what he is studying, where, what he has stopped, which subject is going on, what is the connection. Many students do not know. Whenever they are free, they come. Whatever enters in their mind enters. But what I have missed the subject, like our children, how much homework they do, if they miss the class because of fever, they are not able to attend the school. What they do? And they take the notes of that colleague and take all of them, go home and write all those. We used to do like that, all of us. We did it. And for that itself, Amma Appa helps us also. And we do all the notes, we copy from the colleague. That sincerity is there in college, school education. Inevitable. But the same is with regard to Vedanta study also. The student has to recognize that. If the student want to claim, I am Brahman, I am liberated, without that homework or without that study, systematically, under the pervasiveness of the teacher, under the guidance of the teacher, under the footsteps of the teacher, if the student is not there, that student cannot claim I am Brahman, cannot say I have understood, cannot have the courage to say that I am Brahman alone. Impossible. It is very, very, very sure it is impossible. That is the reason Krishna says, Manushyanam Sahasresh. Raja Vidya, Raja Guhyam, Manushyanam Sahasresh. Kaschita Yatati Siddhayena. Therefore, the commitment, your sincerity, your devotion towards the study alone helps, nothing else. How it comes? If you have a will here, there is a way for that. First you develop a will for that, desire for that. Bhagavan provide all the way how to get it. That is Bhagavan's job. But in my decision, in my effort side, there should not be any lapse. How it works, it is his job. But commitment, that decision making, that nirnaya, that desire is from my side. This is called Atma Kripa, I call it. Now, Atma Kripa's side, if there is a lapse, even Bhagavan cannot take any steps. That's why Viveka Vairagya must be powerful, full extent. If they are lacking, Bhagavan also cannot help. Bhagavan is ready to help, but how much your interest is, a lukewarm interest or warm interest? Bhagavan cannot decide that. The student has to decide. Atma Kripa, that is. Ishwar Kripa, to tap, Atma Kripa has to be tapped first. Where there is a will, there is a way. We don't take it, this proverb, just like that. I respect this statement, very, very powerful statement. Where there is a will, there is a way. Where is powerful Viveka Vairagya, Tivra Mumukshutvam, Bhagavan provide the way for that. So that is called confidence. A confident student claim, I am Brahman, I have understood, this is that knowledge, nothing else I require. Job is over, Shravanam is over. But inadequate in terms of quantity, inefficient in terms of quality, that students, they require Nirguna Brahma Upasanam. For such students, Vidyaranya want to help, doesn't matter, you can do Aham Brahmasmi Dhyanam. Aham Brahmasmi Dhyanam is a dhyanam without triputi, that is called Nirodhaha. For a long time, if you practice that Nirguna Brahma Upasana, that is why in Sannyasa Ashrama, Vividasha Sannyasa itself, just enter the Sannyasa Ashrama, they stop Veda Upasana. They stop Veda Upasana. They take to that Hamsa Gayatri, Soham Brahma, Aham Brahmasmi, Amsa Mantra, they take up. No Bheda Upasana. Even Vidisha Sannyasi, starting, not yet completed the study, there itself they take to Hamsa Gayatri. Deliberately they do that. One day or other, they recognize the truth. All the way it takes the person to that. Nirodhaha Labhi, Nirodha Labhi. When this Aham Brahmasmi is practiced, it generates Pumsaha Antaha in his heart, in his mind. Antaha Asangam Vastu Sishyate. At the culmination of this Nirguna Brahma Upasana, after listening for a length of time, upasana vritti cannot generate brahma jnanam, again that person, that aham brahmasmi vasana triggers and love to look at the mahavakya once again. Punaha vasite asmin. Again he repeats the mahavakya prakriyas, bhagatyaga lakshana, listening to the guru's words once again. All the tougher areas, which are the clues and crux of mahavakya, he looks into that again. Shravanam punaha punaha vasite, again does the listening, second shravanam, with quality of mind, quantity, again looks into all prakrana grandhas and dusting all the notebooks and all, taking out somewhere in the cupboard written 20 years back, 15 years back, take out what my guru said at that particular word. What is that? Yesterday one Ramarai Kavi's Gita Bhashyam I was reading. Whatever said in Vichara Sagara, one point, exactly same point he quotes in his Bhashyam in 9th chapter. 9th chapter, at a particular point, in 4th shloka, Ramarai Kavi writes, same idea he presents in Vichara Sagara. The beautiful, important idea, I don't want to bring that idea here. So, an occasion comes, I will tell you. Really, I was really admired the same point how Ramarai Kavi has written, and that book translated into English, Ramarai Kavi's Gita Bhashyam translated at 1956. In the year of 1956, that book was translated. He wrote much before Sanskrit version of Gita Bhashyam. And Vichara Sagara Nishala Dasa quoted the same point in a different, first Taranga itself he mentioned. In Vichara Sagara class I will mention that. Okay. Because that point those students only can catch where I have said that first Taranga, I will recollect it. Gita Bhashyam and Vichara Sagara, I can relate that quotation. Okay. Anyhow, come back to our, why I want to say punaha punaha vasite. The more and more you listen, you are getting clarity, crystal clear clarity. And the more clarity comes, the more internalization, nishtha, no confusion, no doubt, no vagueness. So this Nirguna Brahma Upasaka, entertaining aham brahmasmi vritti, which is not a pramanam, before Nirguna Brahma Ahamasmi iti jnana vritti to rise, again focus to Mahavakya. That's why he says, asvin vakhyat, Mahavakyat. With regard to aham brahmasmi upasana vritti, in between jnana vritti, there is Mahavakya punaha punaha vasite. Again and again listening to Mahavakya. Not anything else, Mahavakya alone. Vedanta Sara is the one of the best text elaboration of Tattva Bodha. Tattva Bodha is, if you zoom up in such a way, it is called Vedanta Sara. That Vedanta Sara, whole thing, prakriyas are given in that. What is that text I took long ago there in Kesari High School? Everything you took in Kesari High School only, Swami. They are all senior students. First I started my classes there only. Therefore, regularly they have three classes. There is a possibility of studying many texts. It's not too far for attending those classes if they are interested students. So, all my classes within 8 kilometers anywhere. You can reach within 20 minutes anywhere. It is not very far also. What I want to say, quantity of study we should not take it as granted. When even text 1-1 Prajna Grantha presents in a different aspect, different way of presentation. Teaching is same, but he shows in a different manner. Now see the Vidyaranya Swami, how he is showing. Subject is same, Tattvamasi Mahavakyam only, but he is presenting in a different way. For our clarity sake only, we should not take it as an Ella Therinjana Vishayam Dhani. But Therinjana Vishayam Dhani claim, you are Brahman, confidently claim. No. Therefore we need to listen. Punaha punaha vasite mahavakyat kim bhavati tadvadhihi jayeta. The knowledge that I am Brahman, I am liberated, I have understood, nothing is else to be known. Eka vijnanena sarva vijnanam abhavat. I am complete. That knowledge, tatvadhihi jayeta means that triputi rahita nirguna brahma upasana removes all obstructions. Vastu sishyate, brahma sishyate, brahma vit brahma iva bhavate. The knower of Brahman knows Brahman. The knower of Brahman is Brahman, not as a knower, not as a knower, not as becoming. Knower of Brahman is Brahman, no becoming, even not knowing. I am a knower also you never say. I am knower of Brahman means Brahman becomes a known object. Brahman is not an object to know. That's why Jnani cannot say, I am the knower of Brahman, I have become Brahman, I have merged with Brahman. Idhimi solla vali illa. I am Brahman. Brahma vith Brahma eva. Even Brahma eva bhavati also, only for teaching purpose, bhavati also. Brahma eva. Next verse we will see. So nirguna brahma upasaka, nirguna brahma upasana is not to convert the format. Format means what? Triputi to triputi means you understand Ishvara, I am, meditation, all this is not there. Upasaka is not going to convert the format. Format conversion is not possible by upasana. Format conversion is nothing else. I am there, Atma, Anatma is Mithya. Format, binary format, comes only Mahavakyat Jayeta. Mahavakyat Jayeta. Listen again from the teacher that Mahavakya. Nirvikara sangi nityam, nirvikara sanga nitya, svaprakashaika purnatam,
svaprakashaika purnatam,
buddhau chatiti shastroktam. Arohantya vivadatah.
Arohantya vivadatah.
Avivadatah arohanti. Without any argument further. Avivadatah. Without any further argument. Whether he can arrive it or not, is it possible or not, is it doubtful? No. Avivadatah. Without any further argument. Arohanti, they will climb. They will climb means what? They will establish. Shastroktaha buddhau jhatiti. Shastravuktaha, whatever said in Shastra. Shastravuktaha means Guru Uktaha. how Shastra can speak to you? Shastra cannot speak to you. Guru only has to speak. Guru is speaking, but what he is speaking also important. Shastra cannot speak, Guru speaks, but Guru speaks what? Therefore, Shastra alone is Guru, Guru alone is Shastra. Guru Vedanta Vakyeshu Vishwasaha Shraddha. So, Shastra can be unfolded by a competent Acharya, the teacher, who has studied a Shastra for a length of time systematically. The unfoldment of Shastra done by the teacher, the key, unfolding key, Guru only has got. So Shastra Ukta means Guru Ukta Ityartha. Guruna Ukta Shastra. That Shastra unfolded by the Guru, what it does? Buddhau jatiti arohanti. Buddhau. In his buddhi, where the knowledge takes place. Firm knowledge. A doubtful knowledge is not a knowledge. Clear knowledge alone is called as knowledge. Buddhau. In his own intellect. First of all, we all must have a firm thinking or firm conviction regarding knowledge also takes place only in buddhi. Atma jnanam takes place only in buddhi. It is not a mystic experience or self-realization, or it is not a type of event happens in, at a particular time with a lot of extraordinary experiences. I have to rule out this 100% first from my mind. If I don't delete this thought, Atmajnanam, just physics knowledge, takes place in the buddhi. Atmajnanam has to take place in the buddhi. Nothing else. There is no difference. How, Swamini? Physics knowledge, Atmajnanam, how you compare? Knowledge-wise, I compare. Maybe that is objective knowledge. But knowledge, where it takes? In buddhi only. Any knowledge takes place in the buddhi. This is also has to take place in the buddhi. Knowledge to takes place in the buddhi, I have to study the subject. It's not a mystic experience. Moksha is not a mystic experience. Liberation is not a mystic experience. It is not an extraordinary anubhava. Something to happen. Better not to happen, something. If it something happen, means a danger. Pray to the Lord, Bhagavan. Something should not happen. Let my buddhi, let it work properly. Understand. No difference. Dayananda Swami says, any knowledge takes place only in the buddhi. Atma jnanam also, Atma knowledge also takes place only in the buddhi. That is why Vidyaranya specifically point out buddhau in the buddhi only. But many people regarding the Atma Jnanam, they stop the buddhi. Already nil. What is there to stop buddhi? Don't ask any questions, listen. When we say don't ask means don't ask in the beginning. You have to ask questions personally. Because if you ask questions publicly, that question may not be relevant to others. Even if you give answer publicly, they cannot follow also. So listening is publicly okay, but asking the question personally, person to differs it. Therefore, we never allow the student to ask questions in group. We have to ask personally. And we hesitate to ask doubt also in front of others. என்னோட சந்தம் எல்லாம் வெளியில் வருமே சொல்லி கேட்க மாட்டான். we need not feel bad. I can ask any question with regard to Shastra. I can ask my Guru. Who will clarify otherwise without my Guru? Other than my Guru. Therefore, Guru is ready to answer. We need not blindly nod our head with regard to knowledge. Buddhau chetiti, immediately, indeclinable word, avyayam chetiti, instantaneously. Once you listen to Mahavakya again, what happens? Chetiti, immediately, arohanti, that jnana vritti takes place. It is no more a upasana vritti, now jnana vritti. Because of that upasana vritti, abhyasa, abheda, Atma, Advaita Atma Vritti Vasana is triggered by Mahavakya of Guru's teaching. That Advaita Vasana, which is already there in the mind because of previous listening, it triggers. And Aham Brahma Asmi Jnanam takes place. That works. What is that Aham Brahma Asmi? Aham Nirvikaraha Asmi. Previously telling Brahman was, Brahman is Nirvikaraha, Brahman is changeless, Brahman is changeless. So happily telling, now feel shy to say Brahman is changeless. How long you say Brahman is changeless? Replace the Brahman is changeless word by Aham Nirvikaraha. I am changeless. Aham Rukshasya Reniva. That Rishanku words must be my words now. Previously I copied. Now it is not a copy, original. Original. Like that, Aham Nirvikaraha Asni. Aham Asangaha Asni. I am not sullied by anything. I am not attached to anything. I am unassociated with anything in this world. I am not associated or I am unassociated with everything. I cannot be associated. A formless entity, I, the existence principle, how can I associate? I cannot associate. Therefore, Aham Asangaha. Not only that, Aham Nityaha. That Aham you have to add everywhere. I am eternal. Pure existence, consciousness, principle. I lend Chaitanyam to Nama Rupa Prapancha. The Nama Rupa Prapancha, Prakriti borrows sentiency from me. Whether Nama Rupa body mind complex is there or not, I am eternally there. Nama Rupa is there, I manifest through that. If not there, I remain as existence consciousness. Aham Nityaha. Eternal. Aham Swaprakashaha. I am self-luminous. I am self-evident. I don't want anything to verify my existence. I am Swaprakashaha. Ekaha. I am one. Ekatma Pratyasaram. Prapanchopashamam. Ekatma. I am. Therefore, the Jivatma has to be converted into Paramatma, Paramatma has to be converted into Sarvatma, Sarvatma Bhavana has to be converted into Ekatma. The Bhavana is how to add Jivatma Bhavana to Paramatma Bhavana, Paramatma Bhavana to Sarvatma Bhavana, Sarvatma Bhavana to Ekatma Bhavana. Do you want translation? You are all Panchadashi students, I don't want to do translation. You have to translate. Write all these words and go home and translate. What you translate? And ask me, Swamini, whether this is correct or not, you tell me. You can verify. Ekaha aham. Not only that, aham. Eka purnataha. Aham purna. Purnaha, complete I am. Purnamada, Purnamidam, class is not over. Purnaha, aham, complete. What am I lacking? I am Jagadadhishtanam. Everything is sustained by me. I am giving existence to everything. Everything dissolves into me, everything comes out of me. Which me? Lower I or higher I? Higher I, not ahankara. Nothing comes out of ahankara. Everything comes out of aham, atma. Next shloka. Verse number 129. Yogabhyasastvetadartha amrita bindvadishu shrutah. Evam ca drishta dvarapi. Hetutvadanyato varam. Yogabhyasa. Yogabhyasaha tu tadarthaha. Saguna Brahma Upasana, is it recommended or not? For a student who is not having efficient study, not done study qualitatively, efficiently, inadequate in study quantitatively also, and fed up with study also sometime, let me do my own upasana, saguna ishvara upasana, in the nirguna 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 abstract adharam madharam madharam madharam, is so nice. Ajahn Bahum Aravinda Dalayataksham. All these descriptions are giving so cozy for me, pleasant for me. But this abstract, 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 asabdam, asparsham, arupam, arasam. It is dried subject. Suppose student feels, let me go back to Saguna Brahma Upasana for some time. Can I continue, Swamini? Rama Upasana, Krishna Upasana, and after listening 15 years of Vedanta study. Because not able to understand the truth. Wrong, the student, what to do? With interest, somehow it is nearby, class 10 minutes walk, no other class around at that time, my convenient time. So I was attending. Nirgunam, 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 listening, hammered. But I could not grasp anything. Nothing is entering. My Kuchu Guru Ayurappa, my Balaji, my Muruga, 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 Muruga. Nanna irukke solam. Thirupi continue pannatuma. There are students without asking also, they start Saguna Brahma Upasana. Vidyaranya says, you need not go to Saguna Brahma Upasana again. Nirguna Brahma Upasana itself serves like Karma Yoga here. Why we practice Karma Yoga? Tell me. Chitta Shuddhyartham. Viveka Vairagya Jnana Yogyata Prapyartham Karma Yoga. Upasana yoga, chitta vikshepa nivrityartham upasana yoga, saguna ishvara upasana. Karma yoga, saguna ishvara upasana, you have practiced for what purpose? For the purpose of chitta shuddhi, sadhana chatushtaya sampatti, to improve your viveka vairagya. For that you did it. Your sadhana chatushtaya sampatti to improve, you can do Nirguna Brahma Upasana also. You need not go back again to Karma Yoga or Saguna Ishvara Upasana. This will help you. Aham Brahmasmi, Aham Brahmasmi, Aham Brahmasmi. Continue. You need not go back. What you have to continue? Yoga Abhyasaha, Dharana, Dhyana. Continue. Yoga Abhyasaha Tu Hetadarthaha. Here Yoga Abhyasa is equal to Dharana Dhyana. Nirguna Brahma Upasana. First Dharana, then Dhyana, then Nirguna Brahma Upasana. Focusing the mind, absorption of the mind upon Aham Brahmasmi. Dharana means focusing. Dhyana means absorption. Focusing, absorption. On what? Nirgunam Brahma, Aham Brahmasmi Upasana. Yoga Abhyasa Etat Arthaha Etat Arthaha. This practice, these ideas, all these ideas, Etat Arthaha Amrita Bindvadi Shushrutaha. Same Nirguna Brahma Upasana idea presented in Amrita Bindu Upanishad, etc., etc. Upanishad. In Katho Upanishad, this Amrita Bindu Upanishad alone is called as Brahma Bindu Upanishad. Vidyaranya quotes often this Upanishad in Panchadashi. Amrita Bindvadishu Adipadat in some other Upanishads also. In some other place, Kathopanishad also he has quoted. In footnote, many times we saw Kathopanishad also. Amrita Bindvadishu Shrutaha. Shrutaha means heard in the Upanishads. Evamche Drishtva Evamche Drishtadvara Api Hetutvad Anyataha Varam. Anyataha Saguna Upasanat Nirguna Brahma Upasana Varam. Evamche Drishtadvara Api Hetutvat. Here the commentator very clearly writes, because these two words are very vague words. Drishtadvara Api Hetutvat means Drishtadvarena Api Shabdat Adrishtadvara Api. He writes Drishtadvara Dvarena means Nirvikalpa Samadhi Labhadvarena Ityarthaha. Nirvikalpa Samadhi, Nirvikalpa Nirguna Upasana Samadhi Abhyasa. That is Drishtadvarena. By generating the habit of Advaita Vasana or Advaita Samskara. That is the meaning of Drishtadvarena. Drishtadvara Api Hetutvata. Hetutvat means the labham, the phalam, the reason is this. Drishtadvara, this Nirguna Brahma Upasana, Aham Brahmasmi, Aham Brahmasmi, generate the vasana, samskara. Which samskara? I am Brahman, I am Brahman. Samskara generates that jnana vritti. Once you listen once again, it generates, it keeps you always in touch with Aham Brahmasmi. Nirvikalpa Samadhi Labhadvarena Drishtadvara. Creating a habit of Abheda Samskara. Abheda Samskara. Abheda means non-dual. Samskara means habit. I am non-dual Brahman, non-dual Brahman. Listening from the Guru many times. Even though I was half-heartedly, half-mindedly I am hearing, but it enters. Like in womb itself, Narayana, Narayana, he started telling. Because of Leelavati listening from Narada. the stories of Lord Narayana, and inside he boy he is listening. That goes vasana. Vasana generates the habit of that. This is called drishtadvara hetutvat, number one. Drishtarupena. Then adrishtarupena api indicates adrishtarupena. Adrishtarupena means adrishtadvara api hetutvat. Understood. Adrishtadvara api hetutvat means by improving sadhana chatushtaya sampatti. By improving sadhana chatushtaya sampatti, by producing some punyam, this aham brahmasmi vritti, nirguna brahma upasana, produce some punyam. Na karma yogam pandra punyam idu pannada, aham brahmasmi, generate some punyam. Punyam, what it does? Obstacle it removes, pratibandha. Pratibandha it removes. Adrishta pratibandha removed by the adrishta punyam. How this punya has come? Because of repetition. Aham brahmasmi nirguna brahma upasana. So, drishta dvara api hetutvad. I hope you have got it. Samadhi abhyasa rupa nididhyasana drishta lapam. Samadhi abhyasa, it triggers the advaita samskara. That is drishta phalam. Advaita samskara is triggered, drishta phalam. Drishta dvara nirguna brahma upasana gives phalam. Api means adrishta, some adrishta papam removed by this upasana, it gives adrishta punyam. And improves sadhana chatushtaya sampatti, tivra viveka, tivra vairagya. Our students have so much of a refined mind comes to the class. Teacher is waiting for such occasion. Palam, it is called pakataha, paripakataha. Or grass-minded student comes, a refined mind with commitment, devotion, dedication, devotion. That is why the jnani's mind, jnani's level of thinking, the world is entirely different. Their level is different. Pamara janaha thinking at grass level, so different. That is why Lord Krishna differentiated all these people, four groups. Artho jignasur arthaarthi jnani cha bharadarshabha. The beautiful shloka. 99% of people are arthas and artharthis. Crisis bhaktas, business bhaktas. Very rarely you can find jignasu bhaktas. We have to talk of jnani bhaktas. 99.9999% of people are artha bhaktas or artharthi bhaktas. ஏதோ ஒரு பாயிண்ட் 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 எங்கேயோ இருக்க ஜிக்னாசு பக்தா ஞானி பக்த சொல்லவே வேண்டாம். துர்லபம் என்றார், பகு துர்லபம், துக்கதரம் என்றார், கஷ்டம். இப்போ கஷ்டம் கஷ்டம்னு சொன்னால் அந்த குரூப்பில் போகக்கூடாது. நம்ம இந்த குரூப்பில் தான் இருக்கணும். நீங்கள் என்னென்ன சொல்லுங்கள் சுவாமி, கஷ்டம்னா சரி நான் அங்கே போக மாட்டேன், எங்கே போக மாட்டேன், ஆர்த்த குரூப்பிலோக்கு போக மாட்டேன், அர்த்தார்த்தி குரூப்லோக்கு போக மாட்டேன். ஜானி குரூப் லெவல் ஆஃப் திங்கிங், ஜிக்னாசா குரூப் லெவல் ஆஃப் திங்கிங் ஈஸ் யூஸ் டு சே இன் தெலுங்கு, நக்கக்கி நாகலோகானிக்கு உன்னந்த தூரம் அண்டார். ஐ வில் டெல் யூ, நக்கா மீன்ஸ் சம்வேர் ஹியர் ஃபாக்ஸ் ஜாக்கல். ஏன்னா நாகலோகம் எங்கே இருக்கு, நக்கா எங்கே இருக்குன்னா லாட் ஆஃப் லோகாஸ்னா ஹையஸ்ட் லோக்கம் பிரம்மலோக்காக்கு அத்தனை மித்தில சுத்தல பார்த்தால தலாத்தல மகாத்தல அங்கேயோ இருக்கான திங்கிங் பேட்டர்னுக்கு அவ்வளோ டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் இருக்கான். தெலுங்குல சொல்லுவேன் ஒரு ப்ராவெர்ப், அதனால் நெவர் கம்பேர் ஜானிஸ் தட் வைஸ் பர்சன் Shastra person, the one who has got Shastra in his hand, that weapon, don't go near to him. Danger. it has got a double-sided edged knife-like. Out of Karuna, they are in society. They are blessing the society. Ordinary people cannot understand. Even though you are disrespecting them, you are ridiculing them, but they never take it serious because the babies, mother never be angry with the baby. Baby does a lot of nasty things. Mother ke thai ke kovam vanda enna aagum. Baby ke enna aagum. Adhe maadhiri da. Jnanis are all like that. Therefore, first understanding their level is different. First respect them with Shraddha Bhakti. Apram paakalam. Be an astika, be as a religious person. அதே தகராறாக இருந்தன்னா நோ ஒன் கேன் ப்ரொடெக்ட் அஸ். தேர்ஃபோர் திருஷ்டத்வாரா அபி ஹேதுத்வாத் அந்யதா வரம் சகுண உபாசனாத் வரம். பெட்டர் நாட் டு கோ பேக் அகெயின் டு சகுண உபாசன. சகுண தியானம் என்ன துவைத்தம், யுவர் எகெயின் ஜெனரேட்டிங் துவைத பாவனா. அந்யதா வரம் மீன்ஸ் வாட்? சகுண உபாசனாத் நிர்குண உபாசனா இஸ் வரம். வை? வாட் இஸ் த ரீசன்? ஹியர் இட் இஸ் அத்வைத உபாசனா. அஹம் பிரம்மாஸ்மி, தட் இஸ் துவைத்தம். ஹவு கேன் யூ கோ அகெயின் பேக் டு துவைத்தம்? ஐ ஹர்ட் இன் கோயம்புத்தூர் சம் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் அட்டெண்டிங் அவர் கேம்ப் இன் சாதனா கேம்ப் அணைக்கட்டி ஃப்ரம் கோயம்புத்தூர் தே ஆர் கமிங். ஒன் lady is taking classes there. I do not know her name also. She has studied Vedanta, completed her course somewhere in some ashrama, and started teaching for many years. Bhagavad Gita, 2 rounds, 3 rounds she has completed. The students were attending, and suddenly she started upasana, saguna upasana, all these and all keep aside, nirguna. I want to start again. She has taken Vishishtadvaita. Vishishtadvaita, way of worshipping, puja, all these things. The students are confused. Swamini, after teaching long time, and when she started like this teaching, we are really confused. What to do? Prarabdha, you know. After long time of Bhagavad Gita teaching, how can you go back again to Dvaita? That means what you were teaching is not clear to you. What Bhagavan Krishna said. And Bhagavan Krishna said, with all mudhas, they are taking me as Saguna Krishna. Krishna himself said, are you not able to understand Krishna's words? Some prarabdha, obstruction, and confusing the people. Vidyaranya says, never. அந்யதா வரம் சகுண உபாசனாத் பேத உபாசனா சோகமித்யசௌ பாவனாபிதா பாவனீமதான். சீ, சகுண உபாசனா பேத உபாசனா டு அரைவ் அட் அபேதா. இஃப் யூ ஆர் நாட் ஏபிள் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் அபேத ஆத்மா அஹமஸ்மி, கண்டினியூ இன் தட் ஓன்லி, நாட் கோயிங் பேக் டு பேதா. இஃப் யூ கோ பேக் டு பேதா எகெயின், சாமி சாமி யூ சேவ் மீ, சாமி சேவ் மீ, நீ தான் சேவ் பண்ணணும். நான் என்ன எங்கே போகிறது என்ன அப்படி பண்ண என்ன அர்த்தம் தெரியுமா? ஹி கிவ்ஸ் ஒன் ஸ்லோகா, நெக்ஸ்ட் ஸ்லோகா. இட் இஸ் லைக் ட்ராப்பிங் த மோர்சல் ஆஃப் ஃபுட் ஃப்ரம் த ஹேண்ட் ஆர் கிவிங் டு சம் ஒன் அண்ட் லிக்கிங் த ஹேண்ட் ஆஃப்டர் ட்ராப்பிங். ஒரு நல்ல ஸ்வீட் இருக்க மோதகம், ஏதோ கொடக்கட்டை, நல்ல ஸ்வீட் மோதகம் கையில் இருக்க, அந்த வெள்ள வெள்ள அப்படியே வெளியில் வந்துட்டு இருக்க. இவன் போய் அந்த மோதகம் யாருக்கோ கொடுத்துட்டார், ஸ்லிப், சம்ஹவ் ஹி மிஸ் த இந்த ஹேண்ட். அண்ட் வாட் ஹீஸ் டூயிங் நவ்? லிக்கிங் த ஹேண்ட். துவைத்த சகுண உபாசனா இஸ் ஜஸ்ட் லைக் லிக்கிங். Dropping the Advaita Upasana, Advaita Nirguna Brahma Upasana, is like a dropping the Modakam. புரியறத அது ஒரு படமொழி இருக்கு சொல்றார். உபேக்ஷ தத்தீர்த்த யாத்திரை ஜபாதீனேவ குர்வதாம் பிண்டம் சமுத்ஸ்ருஜ்ய கரம் லேடீதி ந்யாய ஆபதேத். When Acharya is so annoyed with these people, they use such proverbs like this. அப்போ அவர் கொஞ்சம் புத்தி வருமேமோ அந்த ஏன் அப்போ நக்கரை ஏன்னு சொல்லுவார் தமிழில் நக்கரதா அந்த மாதிரி ஏன் பண்ணுறேன். தது உபேக்ஷா, தது நிர்குண பிரம்ம உபாசனா உபேக்ஷா, நிர்குண பிரம்ம உபாசனா விருத்தி, அகம் பிரம்மாஸ்மி அகம் பிரம்மாஸ்மி இதெல்லாம் ஒரு ட்ரையாக இருக்க சுவாமி. இட் இஸ் நாட் ட்ரை, யூ ஆர் நாட் ரிஃபைன்ட், தட்ஸ் வை இட் அப்பியர்ஸ் ஆஸ் ட்ரை. அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட், இட்ஸ் நாட் ட்ரை, இட் இஸ் ஸோ ஸ்வீட் ரியல்லி ஸ்பீக்கிங். வை இட் இஸ் ட்ரை, இட் அப்பியர்ஸ் சீம்ஸ் டு பி ட்ரை பிகாஸ் your mind is not refined, your mind still it has got raga dvesha, a mind has got identity with the body mind complex, your mind still have attachment with the saguna bhagavan as the protector savior ishvara, you have that bhavana, leaning bhavana, depending bhavana, you are having a weak mind, a weak minded people are not fit for advaita gnana. Artha Bhaktas are weak-minded people. Arthartha Bhaktas are weak-minded people. Shastra recommends for them, worship Saguna, Ishta Devata. You worship, continue as long as you want. Nothing wrong. You need it. You require it. We never criticize them. Let them be happy with that crisis bhakti and business bhakti. We really ask them to be in that only. If at all a person mature, I want to know what is the truth of this creation, where from I am coming, kastvam koham kuta ayataha kame janani komi tataha. If your mind is, your intellect or your buddhi is questioning, there is a quest in you, there is a quest in you, there is a seeker in you comes out, then Shastra says, my dear, come, I will give you the answer. For that people we are answering. ஏதோ தப்பி தவிர வந்துட்டோம் கிளாஸுக்கு பஞ்சதசைக்கு, ஆனாலும் மாட்டிட்டோம், எங்கேயும் போக முடியல, அப்புறம் போகிறேன் சுவாமி எங்கே. தத்து தீர் உபேக்ஷா நிர்குணம் பிரம்மா கிளாஸ் அத்வைத விசாரா கிளாஸ் உபேக்ஷா நெக்லெக்டிங் இக்னோரிங் எங்கே போயிட்டான் தீர்த்த யாத்திரா. அந்த சுவாமினு பார்த்துட்டு வரேன் சுவாமி, இந்த சுவாமின்னு பார்த்துட்டு வரேன். அங்கே என்ன இந்த முக்கு, தமிழ் தெலுங்கில் முக்குன்னு சொல்லுவா, என்ன வவுஸ், இந்த வவுஸுக்கு என்ன சொல்லுவா தமிழில், சங்கல்பம். அவர்கிட்ட போகிறேன்னு சொன்ன வேண்டுதல்லாம், வேண்டுதல், வேண்டுகோள், வேண்டுதல், வேண்டுகோள் சுவாமி. எப்போ சொல்லிட்டா சுவாமி, ரொம்ப வருஷத்துக்கு முன்னாடி, 20 வருஷத்துக்கு முன்னாடி, ஏன்னா பையன் சின்னவனாக இருக்கும்போது சொன்னடா. இப்போ பையனுக்கு கல்யாணம் ஆச்சு, பையன் பிறந்துட்டா, கிராண்ட் சன் ஆல்சோ ஹேஸ் கம். இப்போ ஞாபகம் வந்துட்டு அங்கே போயிட்டு வரேன். தீர்த்த யாத்ரா, ஓகே, யாத்ரா தத்து உபேக்ஷா நிர்குண பிரம்ம உபாசனா உபேக்ஷா தீர்த்த யாத்ரா கோயிங் டு திஸ் பிளேஸ் அண்ட் தட் பிளேஸ் பிலிக்ரிமேஜ். சில பேர் சொல்லுவான் சுவாமினி, அவர் சொல்லுவான் நீங்கள் ரொம்ப சீரியஸாக எடுத்துக்காது, ஜீவதோஷி சேஸ் நீ பண்ணது பண்ணப்பா, அதுவும் ஊருக்கு சும்மா சொல்லுவா, அது நமக்கு இல்லை, அப்படியெல்லாம் சொல்லி கொடுப்பான். ஓகே, தீர்த்த யாத்திரா ஜபாதீன் ஏவ பை ப்ராக்டிஸிங் ஜபா, டூயிங் லாட் ஆஃப் ஜபா, ஒரு ஜபமானா அதுக்கு ஒரு துணி உள்ளே போட்டுண்டு உட்காந்து போட்டுகிட்டே வண்டிகிட்டே இருப்பான். japareen eva kurvatam, let them do if they want to do adipadat puja etc. kurvatam, if they are doing like this, what it means? It is nothing but pindam samusrujya, dropping the modakam in the hand, eatable, nice food, sweet, whatever is there in the hand, rasgulla, gulab jam, some jamun, something in the hand, mango season, no? Mango season, the mango he is eating and he gave it someone and he licking, lady, licking, lich dhatu. లేఢి లీడహ లిహంతి లట్ ప్రథమ పురుష ఏకవచనం కరం లేఢి లిక్కింగ్ వన్స్ ఓన్ హ్యాండ్ అది మాదిరి ఇతి విత్ విదిన్ ఇన్వర్టెడ్ కామాస్ తిట్టారు బాడు నిన్న తిట్టారు పిండం సముత్సృజ్య కరం లేఢి ఇది న్యాయ ఆపదేత్ దట్ న్యాయ దట్ మ్యాక్సిమ్ ఆపదేత్ ఫాల్స్ అన్ హిమ్ Falls on him means it is as good as licking the hand. If one drops the Nirguna Brahma Upasana and going back to Saguna Brahma and doing puja, prayasittam, karma, parihara, everything doing, it is like just licking. He says, I am not telling, okay, don't think that I am scolding you or criticizing you. Vidyaranya says, this is the lot of those people, immature people. Really speaking, they are really seekers of moksha. They never drop Nirguna Brahma Upasana. Now to be as a staunch Vedantic student is not a joke. Understand? Our apde jolt kudukarar. Are you a really Vedantic student? Apde jolt. This proverb is like a jolt. పూర్ణమద పూర్ణమిదం పూర్ణాత్ పూర్ణముదచ్చతే పూర్ణస్య పూర్ణమాదాయ పూర్ణమేవావశిష్యతే ఓం శాంతి శాంతి శాంతిః హరిః ఓం శ్రీ గురుభ్యో నమః హరిః ఓం